Hi, this is Dr. JMR, JMR Chemistry. Today I am explaining about percentage purity with example. Suppose for example, here I will give you one reaction, that is CuSO4 copper hydroxide dot CuCO3. This is, we can call it as what? Malachite ore. This is malachite ore. So here, this on heating, naturally they decompose into copper oxide, then carbon dioxide and water. Here 5 kg, if 5 kg of malachite ore is present, but here the pure malachite is only 5.20%, but it contains only this much pure, means remaining percentage is impurity. This is first problem, and second problem, but it yields only 78%. It yields only 78%. So finally, here you have to find out how much copper oxide is formed. Means what is the mass of copper oxide. So here, first I would like to calculate here how many grams of from this means pure malachite is present. How to calculate? Generally, here 5 kg. 5 kg is nothing but 5000 grams. Means here 5000 grams. Means 5000 grams means that is 100%. I will give you 5000 grams means indirectly this is 100%. But here only 5.20% means how many grams? That is equals to 5000 into 5.20 divided by 100. What you will get? Only 260 grams of malachite is present. This much grams of what? Pure malachite is present. Now I would like to convert into moles. Mole is equals to given weight by gram molecular weight. That is, weight is given, that is 260 given weight, divided by molecular weight of this Cu taken twice, that is CuCO3, that is malachite, that is 200 and approximately 221. Then that is equals to 1.17 moles. I converted into moles. Then here, based on the chemical reaction, 1 mole of malachite gives 2 moles. Indirectly, 1 mole of CuOH taken twice dot CuCO3 is equals to 2 moles of copper oxide. Generally here 1.17 moles of copper oxide contains how much? That is 1.17 into 2 divided by 1. Then here you will get 2.34 moles of copper oxide is formed. But here I would like to convert into copper oxide. Means I want weight. It is nothing but mass. 2.34 into 79.5. What is this? This is gram molecular weight of copper oxide. That is equals to 186.07 or 0.3 grams, approximately 170, what, 187 or grams of copper oxide is formed. But here what happened, it yields only 78%. It yields only 78%. Means how you will get 78%? 100% means that is 186.03. Then here 78% means how much? 78 into 186.03 divided by 100. So you will get approximately, that is 78% means 145.10 grams, approximately you will get 146 grams of copper oxide is formed. Means here first I converted into the pure malachite, and from this I converted into mole is equals to weight by molecular weight. I got this much moles of malachite, so pure malachite. I converted into, when compared to, from the, based on the chemical reaction, here one mole gives two moles, these many moles gives how much? So I calculated how many moles of copper oxide is formed. So from this, I converted into number of, means weight, it is nothing but mass of copper oxide. So finally, next B problem, it is yields only 78%, means 100% means this much grams, 78 grams means how much. I calculated like this, finally you got 145.10 grams of copper oxide is formed. Similarly, next problem, I will do next problem, that is acetaldehyde, that is, or you take, suppose for example, C2H5OBr reacts with a sodium hydroxide NaOH to form C2H4O plus sodium bromide plus water is formed. At this stage, what is our problem? It is given in the book. It is given that here 3.61 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules of C2H5OBr molecules react with sodium hydroxide to form only 89% formaldehyde, that is C2H4O is formed. So what is the mass of C2H4O? Now we'll do. What we have to do first? First you convert these molecules into mass. How you will convert? So here 3.61 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules of C2H5OBr is equals to how many grams of C2H5OBr? Generally here 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 C2H5OBr molecules is equals to, generally how many grams? What is the mass? 1 mole means what is the mass? That is 125 grams of C2H5OBr. Why? Here this is the gram molecular weight. So generally 1 mole, it is nothing but 1 mole. If you want to do that mole also, you can do 1 mole, or you convert it into directly, you do 1 mole. Suppose if you will take 1 mole here, if you will do like this also, how 1 mole generally occupies Avogadro number. So here these many molecules occupies how much? that is 3.61 into 10 to the power of 23 into 1 divided by 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23. Then here you will get how many moles? 0.599 moles of a C2H5OBr is formed. So now you converted this molecules into moles. Now you compare with this one. 1 mole of C2H5OBr, it is converted into C2H4O. Means they are equal. Means 1 mole of C2H5OBr is equals to gives 1 mole of C2H4O. Similarly, here these many moles, that is 0.599 moles of this one gives how much? It is nothing but you will get 0.599 moles. Similarly, this much moles of water C2H4O is formed. But here I would like to convert into mass. How much moles? You got 0.599 moles. But I want mass into, I would like to convert into mass of this gram molecular weight of C2H4O. What is the gram molecular weight of C2H4O? That is nothing but 44. So that is equals to, how will get, what is the molecular weight? That is 26.356 grams of copper oxide is formed. So you got this much mass. But here what happened? 326.356 grams of copper oxide is formed. But here what happened? This is 100%. 100% means you got 26.356 grams of copper oxide. But here only 89% is yield. 80% means how much? That is 89 into 26.356 divided by 100. Then finally you will get a 23.45 grams of only copper oxide is formed. So once again, here first I converted these molecules into moles. These many moles are of C2H5OBr is formed. I compared based on the chemical reaction. Based on the chemical reaction, 1 mole gives 1 mole. So that is why this much moles gives how many moles? Means naturally this many moles. Then I moles of C2H4O. Then here I converted into mass. I want mass of copper oxide. How? Number of moles into what a gram molecular weight of what a acetaldehyde, nothing but C2H4O. Then here you will get this many grams of copper oxide. This is 100%. But in the problem only 89% is yield. Means 100% means this much, but yield is only 89% means. So that is 23.45 grams of copper oxide is formed. So like this, so here we'll calculate the percentage of purity. So here I request all the students, so if you want any type of videos or problems, please comment. So definitely I am ready to give the respective answers, how to do, but I will explain it by simple way of process. Thank you very much.